Saturday morning, we kick off the Experts program. That means that Luis Alvarez, CEO of the Alvarez Technology Group, is with us on Power Talk. Luis, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Mark. How are you doing today?
Doing really good. Hey, we have a. I want to give a little bit of an advance plug here to make sure that everybody is listening Monday morning at 8:30 for our segment, because Luis has a really neat story to tell, a reveal about something very special that is coming to Salinas, or actually was just brought to Salinas on Friday. So make sure, that's all I'm going to tease it, but make sure you're listening Monday morning to hear the rest of the story, as Paul Harvey used to say.
Exactly. So, excited about that.
So we want to talk a little bit more about cryptocurrency, because they are becoming quite a thing. And for those who are unaware of cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, I guess we could have cryptocurrency for dummies, like people like me. How does it work, and what do beginners need to know about cryptocurrencies?
Well, a cryptocurrency basically is a digital currency. Think of it like almost like using PayPal or a debit card to pay for things. The difference between a cryptocurrency and real money, that things like dollars and euros and all those other types of currencies, is that a cryptocurrency isn't backed by any government or any bank. It's kind of a peer-to-peer, for the people type of currency, so that there's no central repository of cryptocurrency. So there's no central repository of Bitcoin, for example. Everybody maintains, if you have Bitcoin, you have it in something called a wallet, and you own that wallet. And then collectively, all of those wallets represent the total amount of Bitcoin that's out there. And Bitcoin doesn't have a value. Like, a dollar is worth a dollar, right? So it's backed by the United States government and, you know, full faith and blah, blah, blah. Well, cryptocurrencies' value fluctuate because those values depend on how much people think it's worth. So it's much like investing in gold or in silver or in any other commodity. It's only worth as much as somebody thinks it's worth. And if you want to buy an ounce of gold and you're willing to pay $2,000 and the guy across the street is willing to pay $2,100, then it's worth $2,100. Bitcoin is a very democratic form of cryptocurrency. And now it's actually taken a real higher profile with the IPO, the initial public offering of a stock by a company called Coinbase. That happened last week. And Coinbase is kind of like an exchange. You can buy or sell or trade or invest in all sorts of different kind of cryptocurrencies. It's pretty easy to use. You just use regular currency to buy other currencies, cryptocurrencies, and they maintain it for you. So they're just a broker. But their IPO raised over, valued them at $85 billion, which means that this is this is serious now. This is the first crypto exchange that has gone public, but it won't be the last.
This cryptocurrency, there's no physical form. For example, if you own gold, I mean, you could actually ask for the gold in physical form. But with cryptocurrency or Bitcoin, there's no piece of metal or piece of paper or anything like that that is representative of what you own, how much you own. It's all in the cloud, right?
Yep. It's in the cloud, stored in these wallets. And by the way, these wallets are part of the design of cryptocurrencies, is that you can't hide the transactions or the amounts, right? So if I own 100 Bitcoin, then everybody who has access to my wallet, which is a public thing, knows that I own 100 Bitcoin. So, and they can trace exactly how I got those Bitcoins, you know, what I paid for, who I bought it from, when that transaction occurred. It's a blockchain, which is a encrypted, unchangeable audit trail of every activity, every transaction that happens. And that's what makes cryptocurrency so interesting to people, because you can't lie about it. You know, you can't say, hey, I got $1 billion in the bank, but nobody can see your bank account. If you say you have 100 Bitcoin, they know you have 100 Bitcoin. And if you sell one, everybody who wants to know can look it up and decide to know that information. So it's a very democratic way of doing monetary exchange. And it's the reason that the cryptocurrency is so popular with a lot of folks, because they don't have to deal with banks or anything else.
Okay. And what about insurance for that? If I go ahead and I invest a whole bunch of money in Bitcoin, is there any insurance that I can buy that ensures the value of my Bitcoin, that if it's stolen, I'll be reimbursed or something happens? Or is that not possible?
That's not possible. It's really impossible to steal Bitcoin. But let me tell you, it is possible to lose Bitcoin, in the sense that these wallets that are used to store the Bitcoins are designed with there's credentials that you have to enter, passwords and such, to be able to get to the wallets and transact business. And there are many stories of people who literally forgot these passwords and lose access to these wallets. So it's there's a story of a guy who has like millions of dollars. He lives in San Francisco and has millions of dollars of Bitcoin that he can't access because he can't remember the password.
Oh, that, and, remember that story.
If you try,
that's right.
Yeah. And if you try to enter the password too many times, it locks you out forever. So he's scared to try because he's afraid to lose his investment. So there is some technical aspects of cryptocurrency that you need to learn if you want to transact with Bitcoin. But if you go to coinbase.com and check it out, it has a really easy explanation of how this all works and how you can get involved if you're interested. But it's not for the faint of heart. This is a very volatile currency. So it's going to go up and down a lot.
For people who are interested in that, they need to take that as a word of caution, that if they're looking for something that's, you know, guaranteed, there's no FDIC standing behind it. It's not like your savings account at the bank.
Exactly.
And if that's what you want, then that's where you got to keep your money, is in a bank.
Yep. If you want a steady investment and you're risk averse, cryptocurrency is not for you.
Luis Alvarez, CEO of the Alvarez Technology Group, joining us today here on Power Talk Radio, 1460 and 101 FM. Online, it's alvareztg.com. And Luis, the toll-free number for the I-Team.
Give us a call at 866-78-ITEAM. That's 866-784-8326.